Welcome, everyone.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Can we say Sappy Happy New Year still? I know some people are probably going to give us some stuff for that.
You know, I have the general rule that after the 7th, you're not allowed, but because we haven't been live in a while, I will.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's excusable now, right?
Allow it today.
Yeah, but what a wonderful, exciting day to bring y'all inside Maxis today. It's our first Inside Maxis of 2022. How you feeling, Ruski?
I'm excited. I'm also very nervous because I haven't been on for a while. I'm also, so we'll see.
Well, I'm feeling the same way. It is New Year jitters, but it's going to be fine because we are in celebration mode. That is right.
Absolutely. We have a lot of things to celebrate. So we hope you join us.
Yeah.
This is a fun one.
Yeah, and these things to celebrate are, you know, little, big, all around. And after these 2 years, we want to remind ourselves of celebrating the good times and remind ourselves of all the things that are worth celebrating and that bring joy to our lives. So, Ruski, what's one thing that brings joy to your life and is cause for celebration?
Oh, there's a lot of things. I recently went to see my parents after not seeing them in person for like 3 years. That brought me a lot of joy, seeing my siblings in person, you know, gathering as a family, you know, being able to actually travel and go see them. That was actually very joyous. Being with my coworkers now online because of, you know, working from home, like, it has been very joyous all this time. And, you know, I relish the fact that every day I get to wake up and, you know, do things and, you know, hopefully everybody is being safe all around. But we forgot something. For those who don't know who we are, hi, my name is Simguru Ruski. I'm a producer for The Sims 4.
And good me, point.
And with me is Simguru Duck.
Yeah, I'm Simguru Duck. I'm also a producer on The Sims 4. There's a lot of us producer types out there, but thank you for sharing your experience there, Nadia. And likewise to you, things that bring me joy and celebration are just being able to spend time with my family and friends and coworkers.
But also the joy of coffee. No,
the joy of coffee. Yes, I've got my coffee here. So, as we've talked about that, let's head on over into our agenda. Let's talk about what we're going to be doing today. We're going to be welcoming one of the inspiring creative brains that help us make the stream, The Sims, even more creative to the stream today. We're going to be welcoming Complex Sims, and we'll be going over a collaboration we'll be talking about, and then also going over some of his beautiful custom content that he creates for The Sims 4. So please give a warm welcome, everyone, to Complex Sims.
I hope you enjoy our chat today.
Can we get some confetti for the welcome here?
I think we can.
I think confetti is in store.
It's like the signal, confetti signal.
There we go.
It's like we could. I'm glad we have that on demand, just to say.
I know, I'm so glad too. Welcome, Complex. How's it going?
It's going good. How are you guys?
I'm doing well.
Sorry we seem super excited. But I'm so happy you're here with us today.
Yeah,
we're really happy to have you join us today. So today, I'd love to just talk to you a little bit about yourself. Do you want to briefly tell us about yourself? Tell us who you are, what you're about, your background with The Sims?
Okay, yeah. So hi, I'm the one and only Complex Sims. You already know what I do. That's like my line. But if you don't know what I do, I'm going to tell you. I'm 24 years old. I've been playing The Sims for years, like since I was a kid. I wear multiple different hats, but custom content is like my specialty. I know everybody loves custom content, and it gives you like a piece of me in your game. Every time you download it, people come, they request me to make different things. I make them and they love it.
That's awesome. And look at some of this beautiful content. Oh, what do you God, think, Ruski? Yeah.
I love it. I love the nails.
Yes,
I wish I could wear those nails. I can't because I will break them in a jiffy, but I just love it. I love also how you place your the photos so you show everything.
That's yeah, awesome. I love good camera angles. That always gets them.
Good camera angles are always really important.
Oh, I love that dress.
I do too. That's so beautiful.
I love that dress. I really do.
Thank you.
I love the hair.
Now, as we're going, yeah, sorry, go ahead.
When did you start playing The Sims? What made you like, oh my god, this is the game for me, or what keeps you playing?
So I started playing The Sims when I was 6 years old. The first Sims game I played was Bustin' Out. And my aunt had actually borrowed it from a friend at school, and they brought it to the house. And I played it, and I just fell in love with the console versions first, Bustin' Out, Urbs. Those are like the best like Sims console games ever to me. And then I moved over to PC with the original and the base game. And I just loved how with the game, there's so many different possibilities and stuff that you could do inside the game. Like, especially like Sims Superstar is my favorite expansion pack of all time. Like, you could go to the studio, then there was Making Magic, like the Magic Duels, and even with the Sims 4's Magic Pack, it kind of mirrors it. You could still do the duels and different things. So I just love the game because you could just do anything. You could, the saying is true, like, play with life. And what keeps me playing the game is just like the community sense. I love when people share their stories of what's going on. I feel like everybody knows the iconic storyline from Sims 2 with Bella Goth. So like everybody just loves the crazy stuff that you can do inside the game. And I feel like that's what gravitated me towards it and kept me playing.
Yeah, I feel the same too. Even though like I'm on this side of the fence, like working on it, I feel like you can do anything.
Yeah.
The potential for anything, even if it's like outrageous, it's completely, you know, what keeps coming back, right?
Yeah.
So as we're talking, I'm just curious, how did you come up with the name Complex Sims? What was the inspiration, if you don't mind sharing?
Okay, so when I first started in the community, I was doing like Let's Plays and stuff like that. And the atmosphere that I was entering with the Let's Plays, I felt like there were not a lot of stories that mirrored my own Black, LGBT, like just different stories in the community. And I really wanted to bring that to the platform and just show people different like stories and stuff like that from different walks of life. So just the word complex just has a lot of meaning to it. Just different, very multiple different like backgrounds and just things that could be brought to the table. So that's what I feel like that name represented, and that's why I came up with that. And then as time went on, of course, I developed the complex parlor where I would like display my CC and stuff like that, and then the complex way where I share different CC from other creators as well. So I always wanted to just show different perspectives. Yeah,
I really love that. That's beautiful, because The Sims, much like life itself, is very complex. There's a whole bunch of different backgrounds and representations going on. So I love that, and I also love the fact that you share the love with other creators out there too.
Yeah.
So, in this regard, what do you think, what type of content you create? Like, how do you define the style of content you create? Like, what does it represent? You touched a little bit on it, what you were saying, like, about what is Complex Sims, but can you let us know for the people who don't know you?
Yes, so I specialize in creative sim content. And I feel like the name is perfect, Complex Sims, because I create all age groups, genders, just any type of item that you're looking for, I probably have made it at least once or just dabbled in it. And people will come from all different backgrounds. I remember I had gotten a request to do maternity wear recently. And I was like, okay, like I could do that. Like, so it's just like people will come from all different walks of life wanting some type of representation via the custom content or content that I create. And I just create a variety of different stuff. So it fits with the name really well.
Yeah, that's great. Also, we like to see that maternity wear when you
when you release. When it's ready.
Love it.
I have a few friends that might need that. But yeah, that's awesome. Thank you so much.
So just out of curiosity, Complex, who inspires you? Who inspired you to begin creating content? Was there anyone in the Sims community that in particular you draw inspiration from? Yeah, just curious.
The community is full of great creators. I had originally started with just doing recolors of in-game stuff, just stuff that I really liked. And then I had came across Ebonics. Everybody knows Ebonics. Ebonics is the queen.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, I came across her and I really loved what she was doing at the time. And we had developed a friendship. And she showed me different things in Blender. And then I discovered, you know, other people, Xmiramira. She has a platform called the Black Simmer, where there's just a lot of creativity and inspiration. And I was showing some of my content on her forum at one point. So just starting with those two, and then you have a bunch of different great creators, Chase Sims, King Black Cinema, Hard Sway, just a lot of people who came before and after me. So I get a lot of inspiration from people there.
That's amazing. And yes, if you guys don't know any of these creators, please reach out. Like, I've seen so much talent in the community over my tenure in Maxis. You know, it's interesting to see like how everybody actually knows each other in this group, but it's so big. So if you don't know, then please like try to find out. It's amazing what they create every day.
Yeah, it's really amazing, and also just to see how people help each other out in the community and do collaborations and everything.
Yes.
Like that.
Yeah, I have Bergdorf. She always reaches out. There's so many different people. Fresco, like it's just a bunch of people.
Great. Yeah. So, given this, what do you hope to inspire people through your work, like? What do you think other people that see your work or, you know, play with it or even they're looking into getting into CC creation itself, like, what do you hope to inspire?
So I would hope to inspire people to reach out to their favorite custom content creators or just give them feedback and stuff like that. We love feedback. Any way we can improve is, like, gold to us because you're never perfect at anything. There's always room for improvement. I would also hope that people would take it upon themselves to use the game for any type of creative avenue that they want to explore, whether it be storytelling, custom content creation, videos, live streams, whatever. I feel like there's so many different things that you can do within the community. So that's probably what I would tell them to do.
No, that is great. And hopefully that is something that carries on for a long time.
Yeah. And that, I love that, especially about the storytelling aspect, because one of my favorite things about games in general, and including The Sims, is being able to tell a unique, compelling story. So speaking of unique and compelling stories, we have something exciting, and yes, I did say something, exciting to share with everyone who's been watching. We love Complex content so much that we are actually working with him to bring some cast items into the game. How exciting is that?
It's amazing.
Yeah. I just want to say, like, us collaborating with you, Complex, over these past several weeks has been really awesome. It's been great to get your aesthetic, your ideas that we were able to collaborate on with you, and I'm really looking forward to sharing everything with players soon. But I'm just curious, how did you feel about our collaboration so far?
I was like, oh my goodness, this is crazy. It was like so out of the blue to me. I was like, oh my goodness, like they see what I've been doing, like they want to have me come in and help with some things. Like, I thought that was super dope. I was like, I'm definitely gonna send whatever I need to send to help out with the project. And I just love the way everything came out. I feel like everybody's gonna love it.
Yeah, so we know it's gonna be like 3 items.
Yeah.
But we're not gonna tell you guys all like what they all are. No, we're gonna have a surprise. We're looking to see these drop for you guys sometime in February.
That is right, sometime in February.
Sometime in February, disclaimer. But if you cannot wait, you stay until the end of today's live stream, so you might get a sneak peek at one of the items. So just stay tuned. Do not go anywhere.
Yeah. All right. So thank you so much, Complex, for joining us today. It's been really awesome getting to catch up with you in person. I know that you and I have chatted quite a bit over email, but I'm so happy to have you here. And it's been awesome talking to you today.
Likewise. It's been awesome meeting you and meeting you like in person or through online, but in person, as I've seen your work over time. So thank you so much for collaborating with us and joining us today.
Anytime. Call me again.
All right. Have a great day. And thanks again. Now, we can't, Ruski, just talk about all this celebration with actually having something to celebrate for everyone out there. So we're going to be giving away some codes. Cue the confetti.
As always, but especially today, we're about giving good vibes. The year started hopefully in a good foot for everybody, and we'd like to surprise some of you that we have noticed in the chat today, and we have that have been in this mode of super good vibes. So check your Twitch DMs later today for a game code of your choice.
Yes, so thank you everyone out there for spreading positivity that we're about to read. Apologies in advance if we butcher the pronunciation for some of these usernames.
Yes, please bear with us. So the list goes as Chris Likai, just time for gaming, beans_online, Kisamiri, Sandwich Machine. Although the sandwich machine, the sandwich machine, the New Yorker guy, Drunch0T0, CHZ_pizza, but
cheese pizza,
meat, Pwenza, Little Ron Gal, Star Prince B.
Congratulations to all of y'all. Can we get one more confetti? There we go.
Thank you. Also, sorry if I butchered your username. I apologize wholeheartedly. Thank you so much for joining us today and, just keeping good vibes in the chat.
Yeah, thank you very much. We do appreciate you all helping to make our community a better place. So thank you so much. All right. So we've gotten a lot of stuff out of the way on the stream so far. So what's up next? You ready for some 411?
What's the 411 drop? What's the 411?
Now, if you're not familiar, The Sims 411, this is where we talk hot topics and we go over a sneak peek of what's coming to the base game. And then all of what we're about to tell you right here can be reread in the recap on January 21st on our blog.
Yeah, so watch out for the blog. We try to keep everything in there, so... So be mindful of that.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
No, thank you. All right, so first up, we have a status update on customizable pronouns coming to The Sims 4. So I will provide this update here real quick before we get into it. Now, back in May of last year, you all know that we announced our pursuit of customizable pronouns in The Sims 4. And we promised to do a fireside chat with y'all and give a status update of where we are in the production process. And that's what we're about to do right now. You heard it right here in The Sims 411. So today we'll share some insights into our process of adding customizable pronouns to The Sims 4. Now, we know that this feature is near and dear to many of you, as it is to us as well. In our world today, we believe that gender neutrality plays a critical part in working towards a fully inclusive society. The Sims continues to evolve, and we as a team continue to learn and work on making our game more inclusive, step by step and day by day. While to date, we do need to acknowledge that we've messaged you with the terminology non-binary pronouns, we do want to acknowledge that gender-neutral pronouns are not just for non-binary people, and we're going to continue to share with you our work on customizable pronouns moving forward. We just wanted to make sure that that was clear. Now, as you know, this is a work in progress. We're sharing with you stuff that's happening as it comes. And as we take this journey together, we're really excited to take you behind the scenes today and show you where we're at in production. So we're going to start off by describing what this new feature is about and what it will entail once it's ready for release in The Sims 4. Then we'll look at some research we've done to date. For that part of the discussion, we'll be joined by our partner, Ray, at It Gets Better, who's been advising us with valuable insight on gender-neutral language. We'll also show you an inside look today that will give you an idea of how this feature may look in the game. Now, please note that anything we're about to show you here and the images are all a work in progress. It's really awesome that we're able to share you this work that's in progress and exciting to do so. But please note that this does not yet represent the final results, so some things may change. Now, another quick note, as we had to juggle schedules and time zones for many of our different participants in today's fireside chat, we are still working from home as well. We met with everyone beforehand and we pre-recorded it. So without further ado, let's jump right into the video. Enjoy, and we'll see you soon. Everyone, now to get us started off, I'll go ahead and introduce myself. My name is John. My pronouns are he, him. Some of you may know me as Sim Guru Duck, but I am a producer here on The Sims 4, one of the many producers on our team. Ray, our esteemed guest, would you like to go next?
Sure. Hi, everyone. My name is Ray. I use they, them pronouns, and I'm the education coordinator at the It Gets Better project.
I'm Alistair. My pronouns are he, him. I'm an experienced designer on The Sims 4 team, and I'm also known as Sim Guru Felix.
Thanks. Welcome both. Rachel, let's go with you next.
Hi. I'm Rachel, they, them pronouns, and I'm a game designer on The Sims 4.
All right. And last but certainly not least, Veronica, would you like to go ahead?
Yeah, sure. So my name is Veronica Morales, and my pronouns are she, her. I'm one of the leads of the Inclusive Language Initiative within the EA localization team.
Well, thank you everyone for sharing your names and pronouns. Welcome to the stream today. So to get us started, we're working on a feature that will allow our players to customize their pronouns of Sims in CAS in The Sims 4. What we're working on right now and what players will eventually see in the game is the first iteration of this feature. As we said earlier today, this is an ongoing learning and development process for us, and we will continue to update this feature over time. Now, the ability to customize and set pronouns for The Sims will allow for even more freedom of expression amongst our players. Gender-neutral custom, that is a hard thing to say, y'all. Gender-neutral custom pronouns will be an additional option for greater representation in The Sims 4. We've been doing a lot of research for this feature, and not only research to understand the aspects we need to consider from a technical and game development point of view, like text strings and coding considerations, but also to learn what it takes to make The Sims inclusive of gender-neutral language, as well as linguistic challenges we face with the game that's translated into 18 different languages. Now, during our research phase, we've teamed up with some amazing subject matter experts, like our partners at It Gets Better. Ray is here representing It Gets Better. Now, Ray, I know that we said subject matter experts here, but just to note that the non-binary experience is one that's shared by many different people around the world, and no two people have the same experience, correct?
100%.
Right. Well, welcome. In our conversations with you and your team, as well as our partners, including GLAAD, in addition to It Gets Better, we discussed what it means for The Sims to be gender neutral. Pronouns are an important element of gender neutral inclusivity, but certainly not the finish line.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, taking a step back and looking at the society as a whole, we can't just stop at incorporating pronoun usage in our day-to-day. It has to go much deeper than that. There's an internal process. There's a difference between memorizing pronouns and actually unlearning the gender binary, gender roles and expectations, and really understanding the complexity of every single human's gender identity, expression, and experience. And alongside that internal work of fully understanding and accepting the gender spectrum or the gender galaxy or the gender playground, we need to continue to implement policies and structures and protections and systems that support this internal understanding. Our society needs to be built in a way that can adapt to this ever-evolving realm of identities and the experiences that come along with that. The Sims can work in a really beautiful way towards reflecting that evolution. I mean, it's a virtual world where you get to be who you want to be. And I think that is such a unique position to be in, to be a guiding light in how we can build that kind of world IRL.
It certainly is an ongoing evolution, and us as developers and our teams working for this game will follow this evolution to the best of our abilities. But that being said, we know that this feature will not make The Sims 4 100% gender neutral. We still have the selection for male and female in cast, even with this feature. Now, as we've learned through our investigations with you and working with this game over the years, there are many complex systems involved in creating a sim. And even looking at gender neutral language only, we're aware that the ultimate freedom would be the ability to combine any non-binary and binary pronouns with either gendered or gender neutral language. To give an example, let's say someone might use he, him pronouns, binary, but that person wants to use gender neutral language and refer to themselves as spouse or sibling versus husband or brother. But going back to pronouns, pronouns are still a very important piece when it comes to the greater inclusivity of The Sims. Don't you agree?
Absolutely. I think that's a really important point that although it's, you know, there's so much work that we're always going to be continuing to do, pronouns is super important. Our language shapes the world around us and how we interact with the world. Recognizing and incorporating and practicing what I like to call conscious pronoun usage is really a crucial step towards shaping a world that not only includes, but celebrates transgender and gender expansive people. And it gets better. Actually, we work with a wonderful group of youth voices, which is a group of LGBTQ youth ages 13 to 18. And some of them play The Sims. And I know that they're going to be so excited to see a feature like this where they can be reflected in the game and they can be their true, authentic versions of themselves in game. That's how I personally was able to figure out my gender identity, was in an environment that gave me the option to try on new pronouns. The day that I tried on they, them pronouns for the first time was the day that I was first ever able to recognize myself in the mirror, which as you can imagine is life-changing. And I just know that giving people a space to play in The Sims and play with pronouns and be who they want to be just gives them so much room to explore and find themselves and be their true authentic selves, especially in a society where they might not be able to in real life.
Yeah, I mean, I actually 100% agree. Pronouns are a really important step for me, at least just from my experience. I've known since I was really young that there was something different about me, but it was only about 4 years ago that I was like, oh, I'm non-binary. And that's when I came out. But I played The Sims for years before they came out. I won't date myself, but I've been playing for a really long time. And I actually always used The Sims to kind of play around with my gender identity when I wasn't sure, because again, I haven't known for a really long time. So I was always trying to figure that out and just see what would feel different. And now, of course, I have like tons of sim saves all over the place. I love creating new characters. That's my favorite thing. But the core thing I have is when I have a really tough day, I unwind and kind of let myself feel better and feel kind of safe, secure. When I go to the save that is me in Henford on Bagley, like going to visit my foxes and my chickens, I'm just like, I'm safe here. I'm good. No one's going to, you know, discriminate against me. No one's going to be weird. Everything's going to be cool. The foxes had better be cool and it's all going to be fine. And I just think adding pronouns to the game are going to make that game time feel even more welcoming and kind. And it's just, it's really validating to see your pronouns. I mean, I really can't underscore that enough. It's really validating and it's reassuring. And it's just like a little checkbox. Yep, we're all good here. We all know who we are. And I'm really excited about that. And even more excited to make more characters, since I'm a character making person, with lots of unique pronouns to kind of represent the world that I want to see and surround myself in. So I'm really excited about it.
That's really great to hear. And thank you so much for sharing your experience, Rachel. It's really uplifting to hear that when you unwind, that's how you do it, is through The Sims. So thank you so much for sharing. And this is exactly what we're hoping that this feature will do, make your game feel more welcoming and kind. Now, as we're talking, another important aspect we need to consider is how pronouns work in 18 different languages that Sims 4 is being translated into. Now, there's no one solution for all, but we need to be mindful of the grammatical issues that each of those languages have. Now, let's take the example of the adjective perfect. In English, you may refer to a non-binary person and say, they are perfect. However, this might not work for other languages that have adapted to the gender of the person. An example of this is in Spanish, that there is a no gender neutral option for the word perfect. It's either perfecta or perfecto, with female and male respectively. They are perfect as a gender neutral option also does not translate for languages where the plural pronoun is gendered. For example, in Polish, the pronoun for a male or a mixed gender group of people is idelny, and then for the pronoun for a female group of people is idelne. Now, Vero is one of our inclusive language leads from the EA localization team, and you and your team have been working on how to approach these linguistic challenges across the 18 languages that we translate for the sentence. Can you share some insights into us with this process and how that's going with y'all?
Yeah, sure, John. So to start with, as it was mentioned earlier, there's no common solution for all the territories. So this is the first conclusion that we came to when we started doing some research on how the different languages work. So it has to be treated and broken down to the specifics of the language, because culture, regulations, and the language itself have a great impact on how this topic is handled in the different regions. So linguistically speaking, all different sides of the spectrum are represented in the SIMS language, in the languages the SIMS are localized into. So some languages to have an official accepted and ready to use non-binary pronouns, for instance, for Swedish, they have hen, which would work. For other territories, however, the pronouns are not being included in their dictionaries, which proves that the language is evolving and the acceptance of the news of these new languages is also changing over time. It's the case of the French with the pronoun yel, which was recently accepted in the dictionary. And some countries such as Germany, Spain, or Brazil, communities have started using new non-binary grammar and syntax systems. These are not officially accepted, but they are being used by part of the society, and they feel comfortable with this grammar and system and syntax systems. So on the other side of the spectrum, we have other territories with stricter legal regulations and laws for which the use of non-binary pronouns can be quite challenging. So it's important to point out the richness of the languages. For those territories which face some challenges, there are some ways to resolve these. For instance, we can use the passive voice in order to avoid referencing the subject. So instead of saying they sent me a letter yesterday, you can say the letter was sent yesterday. Another workaround would be to substitute the gender pronoun with the actual name of the character, or avoid using the pronoun in languages where the information on gender and number is already present on the verb form. So these are just some creative workarounds, to name a few. Overall, and most important, is that the linguistic approach that we go for has to sound natural in the context, and it has to feel real to the players, and at the same time, respectful. This is what we are working towards, and we have spent some time informing ourselves and also creating some inclusive language guides for everyone involved in the linguistic process. So the aim of these guides is to set some bases and some recommendations on how these linguistic challenges can be sorted or can be changed or updated.
Thank you so much for providing that really valuable insight. It's quite interesting to hear about all of the regulations that go into some of the different languages other than English around the world. Before working on this feature, I didn't realize that there were some languages that actually had laws governing their use in other countries. So that's really great to hear. And thank you so much for all of your hard work on this, as well as the team with EA localization. We really appreciate you doing the hard work for us there.
Thank you very much. It's going to be very valuable, I'm sure.
Yes. Now, that being said, there's still quite the path ahead of us to find grammatical solutions to all 18 languages. So for the first iteration of this feature, we will focus on English first. But rest assured, other language support will be added as we continue to update and improve the feature over time. Now, next up, I'd love to chat with Alistair, Simguru Felix, to take a look at what this first iteration could look like. So I'll pass the baton over to Alistair, one of our experienced designers, and he's currently working on bringing this feature to life in the game. Welcome, Alistair.
Hello again. This is going to be a sneak peek.
I love sneak peeks.
All right. So, as you all know, this is a pretty recognizable screen here. This is InCast. One thing that you probably noticed in the top left here is something is different here. So if you remember before, currently in the game, it says, hello, my name is. What I've changed here and added here is hello, my name and pronouns are. This is because I feel like, you know, in real life, this is how we generally introduce ourselves. We will say our name and then our pronouns. So I felt like we need, that was pretty important to show that in Sims as well. So I'm just gonna go through this click through. I'm gonna click through here. This is obviously work in progress, as you can see with all the watermark here. But let's just say, you know, I'm gonna put my name, just randomize, Jesse Apple. You can also see here, we have a new drop-down section here, which says pronouns. So I'm gonna click on here. So as you can see that there are four different options here. You can pick whatever you want here. I'll go into the custom one a bit later, but let's just say Jesse Apple identifies as she, her, hers. So I'm gonna click that. As you can see, you know, it snaps back, the pronouns appear right next to her name. And this generally would appear, you know, in live mode where, you know, there's tooltips or any notifications that would refer to Jesse, it will use these pronouns. So let's go back into this menu and let's figure out what this custom section is. So I'm gonna click on this custom. So you can see here, there's gonna be a new UI that pops up. This is all gonna be, you know, work in progress text, but this is generally where you are able to create your own custom pronouns here for your sim. Here are, you know, the examples here of, you know, the subject pronouns, object pronouns, if this has a pronouns here. So let's just say I want to change they to Z, them to Zer, and their to Zers. And you can see as I'm changing it, it would change the example here grammatically. Correct as well. So let's confirm this. Boop. And you can see it appears next to Jesse's name here. So yeah, this is generally the idea that we have. Obviously still work in progress, but the concept is there.
Now this is really awesome, Alistair. So happy to see this here and to share this with our viewers today. So with all of this exciting prototype that you're showing us here, or work in progress that you're showing us here, just out of curiosity, you've got the different options for the planned ones, he, him, she, her, they, them. So you are saying that we were going to be looking into having fully customizable at launch as well?
Yes. That's what we hope to do. We felt like that's pretty important and allows, you know, the player and the sim to really represent themselves and the sims that they're creating.
That's really awesome to hear. Now, I know that some players out there might be a little concerned about customizable option there. Are there any protections that we're going to be looking at in place as we do add that to make sure that everyone's able to have a safe and fun experience?
Of course. I know we have a profanity filter, you know, for example, in the gallery, we are planning on having that as well when we do implement this custom pronouns, because we do want to be much more inclusive than exclusive here. So
that's really great to hear. And just so everybody knows, we do take that profanity filter really seriously, and we want to make sure that we're doing this in the most respectful way possible. So, well, thank you so much, Alistair, for showing this to us. I'm really happy that we were able to share this with our players today. And thank you everyone as well for joining us here. So many of you might be thinking, well, when is this feature going to be available? So as you saw today through the many watermarks in that feature that we just showed, this is still a work in progress and our research and design will continue until we feel the feature is in a good place to be launched into the game. That being said, we still do have a path ahead of us and we want to make sure to check in with you again along the way and keep you updated. Once the first version of this feature is out, please know that we are continuously working on improving the game over time, and each update brings us one step closer to a greater inclusive experience in The Sims 4. Now, we hope you enjoyed getting a behind the scenes look into our process and that we were able to give you an idea of what you can look forward to with this new feature. Thank you again to everyone in this chat today. Really appreciate you taking the time. We've got people from all over the world joining us today. So thank you so much and let's get back to work, y'all. Thanks.
Woo-hoo. We hope that you enjoy that video capture of the pronouns, customizable pronouns feature. it is, I love that you guys are already seeing feedback on Twitter, that you guys are appreciating the intricacies of language. And that is something that we're trying to do as fast as possible. So thank you so much for going through the whole video with us. And we hope to show you more about that feature in the future, for sure.
Yes, thank you very much.
Now, as we are in the season of celebrating, although we should be celebrating something every day, we have a sneak peek into what is coming up at some point. So as you know, we're in the season of Simthing to Celebrate. Yes, I think I said that right.
Simthing. Yes, Simthing.
So, or as I call it, confetti season.
Yes, confetti season. Confetti?
Confetti season. Is there a confetti? No, I guess we...
Nope. Maybe
it's on cooldown.
Nope. There we go. Cooldown finished.
So we have a sneak peek at an upcoming scenario in the future SDX drop. Now QDS it. So have you ever dreamed of having or control or being in this kind of like iconic relationship? We have the power couple scenario for you. Yes. If you want to be as iconic as Mortimer and Bella, or, you know, Batman and Robin, or something related to that, we have this scenario for you coming up at some point very soon. I'm going to keep a date, the surprise. So this is a non-limited time scenario. This will be what we call evergreen. In this scenario, you will be playing as a married couple working in business together. You will have a friendly bet to see who can rise in the ranks of the two CEO first. You know, you can bet on yourselves, don't pay. But we're looking forward to see all the wonderful stories that you create. So do you embark in this race to the top in the corporate world. So
yes.
It sounds like in a world full of conflict, who can rise in the ranks of CEO first? So it's definitely something to look forward to sometime soon.
Yeah.
As always, SDS drops can be a little bit of a surprise, so bear with us.
Well, and we love to surprise and delight you fine folks out there. So, please be on the lookout for that coming soon. Really excited to see this new evergreen scenario. Yes, we did say that right. This is going to be not a limited time one. Looking forward to seeing everyone's reactions to it and see how they enjoy it.
Yes.
And that's not it. We have more sneak peeks for you to come. And you know what? It's been a while since we've seen our friendly freezer bunny. Where is our freezer bunny? Oh, there we go. Look at that. Oh, it looks like...
Where am I?
Okay. I think I love this hat. I love this little hat that I have.
I wish I could hide it. Familiar.
So as we were just telling you about, the next Sims delivery is not far away, and this one will be a special one. So a little bit later on, we will be doing what we mentioned earlier in the stream. We're partnering with the amazing Complex Sims, who's designed three cast items that will be coming to the base game via our SDX drop. Now, this one, we can tell you the date for. This one is coming on February 2nd. Now, everyone loves a nice... Oh, yes, watch out for that date. Now, everyone does love a nice little surprise, and that's why we'll give you a sneak peek into one of the three items. And tell us how you like the other two when they drop in a couple of weeks. So just please note that the screenshot we are showing you right now is concept art, and it's subject to change. But here it is. We have these wonderful robes. Yes, I love them.
I love them. I really want that purple one. Purple speaks to me, but also I really love the detail on the kind of like edge. I don't know, technical term, edges for me with that kind of camo style situation. I really love the detail of Complex's work, and I'm looking forward to see this and you guys experiencing it.
Yeah, and I think out of that one too, my favorite one was the blue with the camo trim. I love that as well. Yeah,
the trim, the edges. Yes, technical term.
Oh no, yeah, I mean edges are the same thing.
So, you know, I'm looking forward to see and the other two items that we eventually will tell you about.
Yes. Once they're released, yes. Now, we do have another thing to celebrate about, something more to celebrate. We have another batch of assets that are coming out that we'll love to show you right here on this next screen. We're happy to announce that we'll be bringing the braided ponytail hair to the base game in an upcoming SDX drop. We feel that the addition of this hair to the base game will further allow for greater representation in the game. We're not finished yet, though, so stay tuned as we bring more hairs to you in the future in the base game. And we've also got some food that's coming up fresh out of the kitchen.
And soon we'll, you know, it's never something is complete without a new recipe. So
yes. Yes, new recipes.
Got a few for you. So we're looking forward to bringing to you guys some East Asian cuisine to the base game. In this SDX update, we'll be able to cook and to eat, of course, sticky rice cake, steamed fish, tteokguk, I think I said that right, galbijjim, and japchae, and mixed pork noodles or jajangmyeon. So these are dishes that are traditionally for celebration, so we hope that you enjoy them in game as we drop it one day that we will find out.
Yeah, just seeing those makes me really hungry. Ruski, which one of those are you most looking forward to seeing in the game?
I'm in for the minced pork noodles. Just weakness. Looking forward to those and obviously the sticky rice cake.
The sticky rice cake, the japchae for me are my go-tos.
Yeah, absolutely. It's I'm looking forward to it for sure.
Yes. All right. Now, thank you so much, everyone, for joining us today. This is a really fun time. We always love doing these Inside Maxis shows with y'all. Thank you, Ruski. And yeah.
Oh, thank you, everybody, for tuning in today. I know probably it's a little bit short, but hopefully it's a good cadence to celebration time. And we hope you guys have a safe week, and we'll see you guys later.
Yep. Bye.